When issuing an ATA Carnet, the issuing office will instruct the applicant on how to download the ATA Carnet app. Once the app is installed and the user has created an account, the digital ATA Carnet can be downloaded. The user can simply type in the carnet number and the PIN code provided by the issuing office and tap download. This is how the digital carnet looks like in the ATA Carnet app. We have carnet details, carnet items, carnet documents, carnet travels, carnet transactions, and carnet notifications. With the carnet now downloaded, the next step is to prepare a travel. Here's how you do it. Tap on Travels. Prepare a travel and fill in the required fields. Tap on the declared goods to type in and add items from the Carnet General List to the declaration. When all is complete, tap on Save. The user should now be able to see a QR code in the Transactions tab related to the prepared travel. Remember, before the first exportation, there will always be a validation QR code to process first. You may swipe right to see the other transaction QR codes. Now let's move on to customs. The customs officer can process the digital carnet through ATA Carnet Customs. After logging in, the homepage is displayed where past transactions are shown and where new transactions are initiated. To start processing a carnet, the officer may scan the QR code or type in manually the carnet number and transaction code provided by the user. In step two, the officer checks the carnet data and validity as he would do when checking a paper carnet. Additionally, the carnet history is also displayed. In step three, the officer checks the goods being declared. In step four, the officer reviews the transaction information, fills in additional fields such as customs reference number and customs remarks, if any, and commits the transaction. In step five, the officer can print a receipt or cancel the transactions should there have been a mistake in the declaration. In such case, the committed transaction will be discarded and a new process will be initiated. The last step is to allow the user to verify the successful transaction. So let's go back to the user and his ATA Carnet app. To verify the successful processing of the carnet, the user will go to the Transactions tab and to the corresponding QR code. Here he will see the verification code field. He may type in the verification code or scan the QR code provided by the customs officer as displayed on the ATA Carnet Customs. The outcome of the transaction is shown. And you're done. Remember that during the pilot, the paper ATA Carnet must also be processed before the user is free to go. More detailed instructions for each step and case scenarios are available from your National Guaranteeing Association. Enjoy a seamless customs declaration with the ATA Carnet Real-Time Lifecycle Management System.